Today in this video, we will discuss RS nomenclature, which is very important topic in stereochemistry of class 12th. So let's start the video. RNS, this R is not normal, small s, it's actually R is capital R and capital S. So this R is actually rectus, and rectus means right, and this S is sinister means left. So this right and left is basically its direction means right hand side. If the movement will be right hand side, then this will be called R, and if the movement will be left hand side, then it is called S. Or you can easily understand it, if the movement is clockwise direction, then that will be R, and if the movement is anti-clockwise direction, that is called S. So for RS is applied for a molecule having asymmetric center or either no asymmetric center. Now asymmetric center means four substituent will be different. For example, in this molecule CH3, H, Cl and bromine. So the center is asymmetric center because it's having four different substituents. So chlorine, bromine, CH3 and proton. So this is called asymmetric center. So RNS will apply. Another type of molecule is alene type of molecule, CH3H, carbon double bond carbon and bromine, and this is chlorine. Okay, so now this molecule is not having asymmetric center, but RNS will applied. Okay, another very important rule for RS nomenclature is that the configuration should be defined. Now, configuration should be defined means, like in this molecule, it is having four different substituent, but configuration is not defined. So if configuration is defined, like chlorine is above the plane or bromine is below the plane, so now this molecule is a perfect example of RS nomenclature. Okay, and third rule is the priority sequence rule. So priority sequence rule is given by Chen in Gold and Prelog, which is simply called CIP rule. So according to this rule, CIP rule. So according to this rule, the atom having high atomic number that is directly attached with asymmetric center give the first priority. For example, let's see in this example, the atom is having high atomic number that is directly attached with the asymmetric center. Now, this is asymmetric center. So this is a chlorine, bromine, CH3 and proton. So the bromine is having high atomic number, so it will give the first priority, then chlorine, then CH3, third, and then this proton, fourth. So this is called the third rule, CIP rule. Now let's take another example. This is fluorine, bromine, chlorine and proton. So again, in this example also, it will give the higher priority because of high atomic number, then chlorine, then this, then this. Another thing is that if the four substituent is on the vertical line, then if the molecule is having R nomenclature, that will become R only. But if this fourth substituent is on this horizontal line, so if R is coming, that will become S. So in, let's take this example, 1 2 3 1 2 3, the movement is anti-clockwise, so S. And now S, okay, and now this fourth substituent is on vertical line, so S will become S. Okay, S will become S. So again, I'll repeat it. If like in this molecule, this is bromine, chlorine, fluorine and proton. So a high atomic number will be bromine, then chlorine, then this. So 1 2 3 and 4. If the fourth substituent is on vertical line, okay, so if the molecule is coming R, that will become R. But if the fourth substituent is on this horizontal line, then R will become S. So in this example, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, movement will be anticlockwise. Anticlockwise means S. And the fourth substituent is on the vertical line, so this S will be retained as S only. Okay, so another example, if this proton is on this horizontal line, this is bromine, this is chlorine and this is fluorine. So now again, 1 will given to bromine, 2, then 3, therefore, then 1 2 3, the movement will be S, okay, anti-clockwise S. But because this four substituent is on horizontal line, so now it will convert it into S, will convert it into R. Okay. Another thing comes when atomic number is same, atomic number is same, so means case of an isotope, then isotope having higher mass will have the higher priority. So let's see the example. Like in this example, this is the tritium, deuterium, then chlorine, then proton. So these tritium, deuterium are the isotopes of hydrogen. So now we'll give the first priority to this chlorine. Now tritium, deuterium and proton. So tritium is having higher mass. So tritium is having higher mass, then deuterium having higher mass, then proton. So first priority will be 1, then 2, then 3. But in this molecule, chlorine is having higher atomic number. So 1 will be given to chlorine, 2 will be given to tritium, 3 will be given to deuterium, and 4 will be given to proton. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 movement will be right hand side, means clockwise. So this will become R. But the fourth group substituent is on horizontal line, so R will become S. So final nomenclature of this molecule is S. Okay. Same type of example is in case of carbon isotope. Carbon is having carbon 13, carbon 14 and carbon 12. So having higher mass will give in the higher priority. So now discuss one simple example where the substituents means where there is no different type of substituent, like C. This is CH3, this is CH3, this is CH3, and this is 2. CH3, 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 and CH3. So this is again asymmetric center because the four substituents are different in the sense this is a directly attached carbon CH3, then CH CH3, then CH2 CH3, CH CH, then CH2 CH3, and the CH2 CH3. So we'll give the priority rule. So here because this carbon is having three another attached directly attached with three different carbon, so we'll give first priority to this, then second priority to this, then third priority to this, and fourth to this. So 1 2 3 1 2 3 movement is clockwise, so R. But but this fourth substituent is on this thing, like horizontal line, so R will become S. Okay, so I think this much is sufficient to find out whether the molecule is having R or S nomenclature. If I'll find some different example of RS nomenclature, then I'll discuss in my next video. Thank you.